Libya for more than 2 years. And after, my name is John Favor. After many years I've been in Libya, I was taking on a career, hoping that things would go well, but I never knew that it was a prostitution job, that it was going to do something that is not out of the will of God. But I so much thank God, after everything, I did not die on my way crossing to the Mediterranean Sea. But all I'm just saying is that Father Amaro has done so much for us. He has made more than 160 people. He has given them hope. He has prayed for us. He has done a lot of things for us. He has killed cow. He has already prayed for us, giving us hope, which we have lost, encouraging us, still putting us in the hands of God, and we are still begging the government to see our sister because we have no hope. We have lost everything. I have spent no less than 100,000 naira just to make sure that I become something. But all the same, nothing came out. All we are calling the Nigerian, we are calling the public, the government, Okowa, everybody, the Christian organization to come to our aim, to help us. So many people came back with disease, deadly disease, sicknesses. So many died on their way coming, some in the sea. But all we are just saying is we are returning the glory and adoration to the Almighty God. Amen.
My name is Eugene Olugbe. I traveled to Libya in 2016, October 1st. So when I was going to Libya, I was not told that Libya is doubt, that they don't have government. My brother told me that he will take me to Libya and he will give me a job there to do that is going to make life comfortable for me. Then I paid money to him. I paid 210,000 naira to him. So we now go on our way to Libya. I spent 7 days in desert, no food, no water. As in, the journey was not easy at all. People are dying. Some of my friends, I lost them there. So getting to Libya, they now sold us again to one Arab boy. Those Arab men now started beating us. They lock us in a place which they call tranquil. They now beating us, asking us to pay some amount of money again. We now ask them, how much are we going to pay? They say we should pay extra 210,000 naira so that we can be free. So we now pay that money. That was how we are free from there. Then after then again, on our way to seaside, they now kidnap us again and lock us in the prison and ask us to pay some money again so that we can be free. So we now pay, what I paid there was 230,000 naira again before I was free. So after I'm free from that prison again, I'm now started gathering money again, running from one place to another, because Libya is not a place, it's not like Nigeria here that you can move around, you can go anywhere you want to go. Libya is not like that. You can't even sleep. You can't even close your eye when you want to sleep. You sleep with one eye and open to one eye in case of anything. So all the same, I give God the glory. I'm happy that I'm back to my country. And I'm happy that I'm alive. I'm so happy that I'm alive. I'm proud to be a nation of this country. And this Father Dibie, he have tried a lot. Alex is went us to his church, he's prayed for us, he provides, as he have given us hope. Because many of us have lost hope, including me myself. I've lost hope. Sometimes we do think that we don't have hope again, because that's how people look at us. We still pray that God should give him more power to help us more. And we still beg for the empowerment of the government, if they can do anything at all to assist us. So that is all I have to say. Thank you.
Time on Kevin, on the history of Libya. Let me start from the year I come to Libya, from 2017. A lot of things happened in 2017, a lot of people die. Libya is not easy. Libya is not a country where someone can go, because Libya, as we see Libya soon, I know we say na place where person they go, you go get joy. Because if you wake up in the morning, now first nation, you go still wake up. Because that time, you know, go feel get joy. Because how they think they live, they no go man sympathy at all. Anything they say, they will say beat you. Anything you see on your own, I didn't tell you, if they won't even push you, they're going to risk your life. People for water, people they die. For my boat, people, almost 70 people die. Well, they were 130. So God saved my life. Now I make a day happy today. They celebrate with my father, Dibie. So waiting for our father, they do. They sweet us. Say, I organize us as we return this. We thank God for our life today. But we'll take come back.
I have so many things to talk about Libya. You know, the journey is full of stress. If that journey were to be shown to me then I wouldn't have made an impact to Libya. So the journey is so stressful. I traveled 2016, and my burger promised that I would only spend 2 weeks in Libya to confirm Europe. So not as I thought. So I spent a month in a place called this country after Niger, Agadez. So I spent a month in Agadez before they now took us to. We were 42 healers. Out of the 42 healers, it was only few healers that confirmed the Saba that is in Libya. The rest died, many people died on the way. Like in Sahara Desert, our vehicle spoiled in Sahara Desert. So many persons died because of the heat of the sun. Because the sun is not that far from the earth in Sahara Desert. So many persons died in Sahara Desert before they now took us to Doroku, from Doroku to Saba. There in Saba, I spent almost 2 months before they now took us to Seaside, the place called Suprata. There in Suprata, it was when they were leading us to Seaside, that soldiers caught us and took us to a prison where we were the first set that claimed prison before they now went to the Seaside and start bringing people from the Seaside to the prison. So from the prison now, they now took us to a place called Teromata. There in Teromata they call it deportation camp, but it's still a prison. We spend extra 2 months in Teromata prison before they now took us to Teromata. From Teromata, they take us to Zara prison too, before God intervened. They now called our ambassador. Everybody started having his TC and her TC. And that was how we returned. So I so much thank God that I'm alive, because so many persons died. It is not, I never expected the invitation that Father Dibie invited us, because he does not send anyone to Libya. With his meek mind, with his God-given mind, he called us to entertain us, and also making a promise that he will call some of us, that anyone that his spirit moves to call, that he will call to render help. So I pray that God will continue to bless him in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm Ebube Okafor by name. I'm from Ebonyi State, but I reside in Delta State in Agbo here. So I'm a professional DJ. But before I traveled, I sold my musical instruments to embark on the journey.